they don't do it just one night. They're every night ready to be able to help the guys.
They keep that action rolling. The sprint recovery team here at St. Francis County Raceway.
I tell you what, if these guys turn it loose and really put the hammer down in these heat races, this could get dangerous. This racetrack is going to be like a rocket, so is the cars, too.
Well, this is similar to a prelude to this week's weekend showdown.
You bet.
Because there's going to be some hot, heavy action tonight. It's kind of like the week before Christmas.
You bet. Get tuned up and ready. Of course, with three nights of racing next weekend, all of our Jacksonville guys will race on Friday night. Some of your guys will come up there. You fans are all welcome, too. By the way, we're located on Route 67 north of Alt, about an hour. And we're racetracking at the Morgan County Fairgrounds. It's a high-bank quarter-mile racetrack. A lot shorter than this one before they put on a show. Jared Hall was the featured winner last night. But right here tonight, let's see what our sprint cars can do in heat race number one. Cubby Black and Rodney Redmond about to turn them loose. that number two spot. Now comes third. Racetrack's fast. These guys are going like a rocket.
Thank you.
myself up a win, but I want to tell you what, Steve. I don't normally make predictions, but I'm going to tell you something. That driver, that number 87, put him in a good, strong running race car. You're going to have another drive in Montgomery to put up with. A good job by Joey for the first time in that 87 on a track like this where it's fast and sticky. But here's the winner, ladies and gentlemen, the veteran from Montana, Missouri, driving the number 20. When he comes your way, put your hands together for Danny Long, driver of the number 20.
I'll tell you, David, Keith Burns is going to his home for his first Duke Sprint, only 16 years old.
I think we've got some amazing young drivers coming up that's going to keep this sport alive for a long time, Steve.
You're right, David. Stars of the future. You just saw a few of them. Danny Riesinger's been looking good in that number 15. He'd move over from street stocks to wing sprints. Done a very good job making that adjustment.
Got our fastest qualifiers on the back of this again, folks. Jimmy Mohan and Ronnie Standridge up front with Robbie and Jimmy Farmer. I'm going to tell you what, these guys got their work cut out for them. And if the two guys in the back can go forward, that tells you what our feature is going to be like, Steve.
It's going to be a good one. Dave, again, this track is prepared so well tonight that I tell you, it's going to be a thrill for the racers to be running on it.
Not only the racers, it's good for the fans because they're seeing more speed here tonight than we've seen in a long time. These guys are still cutting some 11, high 11s and low 12-second laps out there in these races that they're putting on. Well, let's find out what they do here. Six laps from now, we'll have the answer to who will be our Trophy Dash winner. Watch them out of the turn. They're all in good shape.
Take it, shake it. track is going to be open after tonight's races, open 24 hours a day, and a popular place to stop. After all the racing action every Saturday night, don't forget to use your VIP discount cards if you have them.
Do you know about the inn in Steak and Shake?
The inn? No, I didn't know about the inn.
Well,
the inn.
Let's find out about it after this race.
Here we go.
Thank you.
it on the back straight, lose some tires in the process. Tough break for him. He'll have to go out on the hook. Got up into those marbles and it drove him right off into the wall. The amazing part of that is the car didn't go over, it sure as heck could have. Just didn't.
Gas and go.
52 Larry Dudley and the 7 Todd Digger, the top four finishers. Semis don't normally take that long, but these guys are driving hard, they're driving fast, and when that takes place, things happen. Beginning to lend a little rubber down on the racetrack now, a couple of 3-6 spots out there, but it'll still be pretty doggone good come feature time. All right, it's time for another consolation event, and here comes the hobby cars. Harry Babb out of Decatur, Illinois, winner, ladies and gentlemen. sorry, Jimmy Farmer, then Mohan, and Nash. Man, oh man, what a race we had a chance to see tonight. And once again, this young man takes it off the trailer, goes out and qualifies third fast, then comes around and wins the feature and down. Once again, a great lot of talent there. He owns this racetrack, folks. That's his second and third feature this year, and what a job he's done. So when he comes out of that race car, let him know that we appreciate his driving skills, because he had to drive for this one tonight, folks. His brother Ronnie wasn't going to back off and give him one inch. Here he is, Robbie Standridge. Okay, let's get over and have a quick word with him. Robbie, another good win, fella.
I'm in that orange number 10. That's the only real brother down there. I figured I'd never get you.
And I'll tell you one thing. We can tell the man up there, he wouldn't cut you any slack at all, right?
No, when we got that last rabbit, he stuffed it in the race in that last rabbit. I figured I didn't get going. I was going to get beat.
You take this thing off the trailer, you go out and you qualify quite fast with it. In this race, it looked like you didn't even have to steer. It looked like it was on a string. You really got your car set up, Robbie.
Yeah, I do here, Dave. I go down to Jacksonville, can't touch my butt. I come here real fast. I can't figure it out.
Well, whatever it is, congratulations on another win, Robbie. Way to go, fellow. Robbie Standridge, winner of our feature event tonight, folks.